Hi guys, see you again in chapter 4, chemical bonding. And now we are going to learn a new subtopic, which is 4.3, orbital overlap and hybridization. So this is the first part of this subtopic. I'm going to give you introduction about this subtopic first. So guys, let's start. Alright guys, in this subtopic, we are going to learn about orbital overlapping and the hybridization of the molecule, okay? So, you are going to learn about how to describe the formation of sigma and pi bond from the orbital overlapping, and then you need to draw and explain the formation of hybrid orbital, and you need to draw the orbital overlap and label the sigma and pi bond of a molecule. So for this drawing orbital overlapping, I will teach you later in the second part and the third part. For this part, I'm going to give you the introduction about this subtopic first. Alright guys, before we look at the type of hybridization, you need to know about the mode of overlap. Macam mana berlakunya pertindihan orbital tu. Overlap tu pertindihan eh. So, kita ada two type of mode of overlap. The first one, we have end-to-end overlapping, which is involve the sigma bond. And then we have side-to-side overlapping, which involve pi bond. Okay, so this is the example of end-to-end overlap. Okay, and then this one is example of side-to-side overlap. Alright, so after this, I will explain to you more about this mode of overlap. Okay guys, so we look at the first one, which is sigma bond. Sigma bond resulting from end-to-end overlap. Okay, so it has highest electron density along the bond axis. Okay, so allow free rotation. Maksudnya kalau sigma bond ni memang boleh rotate dekat molecule tu lah. So kalau awak boleh tengok kat sini adalah kita punya sigma bond between carbon and carbon, and then kita ada sigma bond between carbon and hydrogen. Okay, actually all single bond are sigma bond. Semua single bond yang kita pernah jumpa sebelum ni, itu kita classify sebagai sigma bond. Okay guys, so now we look at how the formation of sigma bond. Okay, so kita tengok overlapping between original orbital. Original orbital adalah orbital yang kita dah belajar in chapter 2. If you still remember, kita ada orbital S, kita ada orbital P, kita ada orbital D. So ini adalah original orbital. For example, dia boleh overlap between orbital S dengan orbital S. Sama ada 1s dengan 1s. Okay, so arrow yang dalam ni refer kepada elektron. Kita tahu one single bond contain two electron. So ini menunjukkan overlapping original orbital, di mana dia membentuk satu single bond. Okay, so after this, you are going to draw this orbital. Okay, ini adalah contoh yang berlaku dalam molekul hydrogen gas. So kita tahu, if we draw the Lewis structure for hydrogen gas molecule, it should be like this. So this one show the sigma bond involved in hydrogen molecule. And then kita ada overlapping between 1s orbital with 2p orbital. This one involved in hydrogen fluoride molecule. Okay, sebab if you draw the Lewis structure, it should be like this. So actually dekat fluorine ni sebenarnya ada lone pair kan, cuma kita tak tunjuk lah. Kalau you all nak tunjuk pun boleh. Sebenarnya dia ada tiga pasangan lone pair dekat situ. So itu adalah Lewis structure yang sebenar. Okay, so kita tahu dia ada satu single bond. So satu single bond ni refer kepada satu sigma bond in HF. So kita tahu hydrogen orbital yang ada pada dia adalah 1s orbital, while fluorine, the valence orbital in fluorine yang ada adalah 2p orbital. So that's why 2p orbital akan overlap dengan 1s orbital. So yang ini saya akan jelaskan lebih lanjut bila kita belajar drawing overlapping orbital later. Okay, next kita ada example between chlorine molecule. So chlorine, dia ada 3p orbital, okay, di mana ada satu single electron yang ada pada valence electron. Okay, so ini overlapping between 3p orbital with 3p orbital of chlorine atom. So dia akan form juga sigma bond. Okay, later we are going to learn about hybrid orbital. So between hybrid orbital juga boleh form sigma bond. Ini adalah contoh hybrid orbital yang kita ada, sp orbital, sp hybrid orbital. Okay, so kejap lagi kita akan belajar lebih lanjut. Okay, so this is the example of hydrogen molecule yang saya dah tunjuk tadi. Kenapa dia berlaku overlapping between 1s orbital with 1s orbital? Okay, see here. If you look at the electronic configuration of hydrogen atom, dia mesti jadi macam ni kan, 1s1. So kalau you draw the orbital diagram, dia akan jadi macam ni. So sepatutnya you all dah mahir buat electronic configuration and orbital diagram, because we are going to apply this concept in chapter 4. Alright, so another hydrogen atom juga adalah sama. Alright, so kita tahu satu elektron ni akan share with the other one electron from hydrogen atom, it will form one single bond. Baru kita dapat single bond tadi kan, di mana kita dapat macam ni. So ni single bond ni lah adalah sigma bond. Okay, so that's why the orbital involved here adalah orbital 1s. Sebab apa? One single electron here berada dalam 1s orbital will overlap with another 1s orbital, because dia ada satu elektron juga. Nampak eh? So dia overlap antara dua ni. So dia share the electron, will become like this. Kalau awak tak buat bentuk 3D macam ni lah, awak lukis yang 2D sahaja. So this both electron dia dah overlap, so actually it will form the sigma bond, or kita biasa panggil sebagai single bond. Okay, next kita tengok kepada another example, hydrogen fluoride. Ini adalah the real Lewis structure yang saya dah bagi tahu tadi. So untuk hydrogen, we write the electronic configuration first and then draw the orbital diagram. Okay, kita buat orbital diagram sebab nak bagi you nampak dekat mana single electron itu berada. Okay, so kita buat untuk fluorine. So ini adalah electronic configuration of fluorine, and then kita hanya fokus, untuk buat orbital diagram dalam chapter 4 ni, kita fokus kepada valence orbital diagram. So ini adalah valence electron yang ada dalam tu. Okay, so kita fokus yang tu je. Maksudnya petala yang paling luar sahaja. So you draw the orbital diagram for the valence electron. So kalau awak lihat 2s2 dah penuh, so kita ada 2p5. So kita ada one single electron here. So this single electron will share with this single electron, form one single bond. Itu yang saya maksudkan tadi. So kita tahu one single electron from hydrogen come from 1s orbital, while fluorine single electron come from 2p orbital. So the overlapping orbital involved between this hydrogen fluoride adalah between 1s orbital and 2p orbital from fluorine atom. Okay, kita tengok another example here. Kita ada fluorine molecule, right? So fluorine molecule, if you draw the Lewis structure, it should be like this. Nampak eh? Okay, so we write the electronic configuration and draw the orbital diagram for the valence electron here. So if you look at this fluorine atom, sama kan? So both single electron berada dalam 2p orbital. Dia berada dalam 2p orbital. Bermaksud orbital yang awak kena lukis adalah overlapping orbital between 2p orbital. So p orbital shape dia adalah dumbbell shape. So you draw the orbital overlapping like this. Okay? So ini adalah between fluorine atom dengan fluorine atom. So awak lukis macam ni ya, yang macam ni cuma 3D structure. Okay, tak perlu tunjuk all the axis here. Alright. Okay, so ini adalah cara awak lukis. So sebab tu you kena tahu buat electronic configuration and the orbital diagram. So ingat, orbital diagram yang kita fokus adalah valence electron. Alright guys, so next we look at pi bond. Okay, pi bond resulting from side to side overlapping. Okay, so has two region of electron density. Yang atas adalah pi bond dan yang bawah akan jadi sigma bond. Dia akan ada dua version. Okay, so ini cara awak lukis overlapping orbital for pi bond. Okay, pi bond dia punya overlapping adalah side to side. Kalau sigma bond, overlapping dia adalah end to end. Okay guys, so look at this example. So how to identify the pi bond? Senang je kelas. Bila you nampak je ada double bond, okay, double bond should consist of one sigma bond and one pi bond. Okay, for example here, we have oxygen molecule. So if you draw the Lewis structure for oxygen molecule, it should be like this. Okay, so this oxygen molecule consists of one double bond. So tadi kita dah tahu satu double bond mesti ada dua region, di mana dia akan ada one pi bond and one sigma bond. Okay, so that's why oksigen akan ada dua perkara ni lah. Tapi kalau dalam single bond, hanya ada sigma bond. Okay, next we have triple bond. Triple bond consists of one sigma bond and two pi bond. So for example here, kita ada nitrogen molecule. So nitrogen molecule consists of two pi bond and one sigma bond. So be careful ya, guys. You need to understand about this thing before we learn about hybridization after this. Okay, next we look at hybridization. Biasa you all pernah dengar kan, hybrid. Hybrid ni umpama macam kita buat proses kacukan. Macam tu. Kalau sebelum ni, kalau awak belajar biologi, kita ada kacuk buah-buahan kan. Tapi dalam chemistry, kita ada hybridization in orbital. It means that kita akan hybridkan orbital S, orbital P, orbital D. Kita akan kacukkan orbital S, P, D menjadi satu hybrid orbital yang baru. Okay, so what is mean by hybridization? Secara kimianya kan? So mixing of two or more atomic orbitals to form a new set of equivalent hybrid orbital. Okay, so ini maksud dia. Ini definition dia. Okay, so ini adalah important thing yang you kena ambil tahu. Okay, kalau tak memang you akan pening nanti. Okay, hybridization only for central atom. Okay, central atom yang berada di tengah-tengah. ataupun central ion, dan juga surrounding atom form multiple bond with central atom. Okay, contoh saya bagi dekat sini, kalau awak ada this Lewis structure, saya lukiskan Lewis structure untuk H2CO. Okay, kalau awak lihat dekat sini, kita punya central atom adalah carbon. Okay, so ini adalah central atom. So central atom ni akan wajib you all buat hybrid orbital nanti. Dan pada masa yang sama, surrounding atom atau terminal atom yang form multiple bond with central, siapa? Oxygen ke hydrogen? Yes, oxygen adalah surrounding atom that form multiple bond with central atom. So this atom juga wajib buat hybridization nanti. So ada dua atom yang awak wajib buat hybridization. Untuk hydrogen atom dekat sini, tak perlu buat hybridization. Tak perlu kelas. Okay? So, awak hanya buat original orbital sahaja. Jelas tak dekat sini? Okay? Okay guys, kita tengok type of hybridization involved in your syllabus. Okay? Tak banyak, cuma ada 5 sahaja. Okay, before this, in subtopic 4.2, we already learned how to identify the electron group, the electron group arrangement. And now, you need to relate all that thing with the type of hybridization. So, memang you kena faham 4.1, 4.2 sebab dia ada relate dengan 4.3 subtopic. Okay, so before this, kita tahu, kalau 2 electron group, the arrangement should be linear. So, the type of hybridization akan jadi sp. Maksudnya kita akan kacukkan satu orbital s dengan satu orbital p. Sebab apa? Awak boleh kira je pakai jari. S1, P1. Cukup 2 electron group. Nampak tak? So, dia punya shape adalah macam ni. So, this is the hybridization orbital for sp hybrid orbital. So, dia akan ada 2 kelopak bunga macam tu. Okay? Dia macam ala-ala bentuk dumbbell lah. Okay? Next, we look at 3 electron group. So, the arrangement trigonal planar. Trigonal planar, if you still remember, the arrangement like triangle shape, kan? So, the type of hybridization is sp2. Kenapa sp2? Okay, kira dengan jari awak. Okay, 3 electron group. Kita kacukkan satu orbital s, satu orbital p, satu lagi orbital p. Maksudnya kita akan kacukkan 2 orbital p. Sebab apa? Kita tahu p orbital ada 3 jenis. Kita ada px, py, pz. So dekat sini tak kisahlah p apa pun yang kita kacukkan. Nampak? So dia punya arrangement trigonal planar. So you need to draw the shape of trigonal planar. So inside here, you nampak eh? Kelopak dia kali ni ada 3 kelopak. Sebab apa? Sebab 3 electron group. So each loop here, you need to label with sp2. Yang ni you label sp. Boleh nampak? Okay, next we have 4 electron group. So the arrangement is tetrahedral arrangement. And the type of hybridization is sp3. Kira 1 s orbital, okay, hybrid with 3 p orbital. 3 p orbital dikacukkan dengan 1 s orbital. Cukup tak 4 electron group? Cukup kelas. Okay, cukup. So, shape yang awak kena lukis adalah shape tetrahedral di mana dia ada 4 loops. Okay, dia ada 4 kelopak bunga dia. Boleh nampak kan situ? So, awak tengok, ingat balik chapter 4.2, tetrahedral madam kata ala-ala bentuk kaki ayam macam tu kan? Kan nampak macam bentuk kaki ayam tu? Betul? Okay, next we have 5 electron group. So the arrangement is trigonal bipyramidal. Look, the type of hybridization here. Not sp4. Bukan sp4 ya. Dia adalah sp3d. Kenapa bukan sp4? Kenapa tak boleh? Kelas. P orbital cuma ada 3 jenis sahaja. Okay, madam repeat. P orbital consists of px, py, pz only. So kalau kita nak cukupkan 5 electron group, s satu orbital, p baru ada 3 orbital, baru 4 kelas. So nak cukupkan 5 electron group, kita kena kacukkan satu orbital d. We know that d orbital consists of 5 orbital, kan? D ada banyak, dia ada 5 orbital. Ambil satu lah. Okay? So dia jadi sp3d hybridization. So bila 5 electron group, arrangement trigonal bipyramidal. So when you draw the hybrid orbital, it should be like this. Consists of 5 loops. And tengok kedudukan loop ni mengikut bentuk trigonal bipyramidal. Okay. And the last one, we have 6 electron group, octahedral arrangement, and the type of hybridization is sp3d2. Nampak? sp3d2. Kita tambah lagi satu kacukkan orbital d. Nak cukupkan 6 electron group. 1 orbital s, 3 orbital P, 2 orbital D. Cukup tak 6 electron group? Yes. So when you draw the hybrid orbital of sp3D, it must consist of 6 loops. Okay? So tengok, ada 6 kelopak bunga. So dia punya arrangement of this loop according to octahedral arrangement. Boleh? Okay guys, so now we look at the example how to determine the hybridization state. Hybridization state means that type of hybridization for the central atom. So what we need to do first class, you need to draw the Lewis structure. Kalau baik lagi, buat molecular shape. Okay, so kita ada SF4. So I draw the Lewis structure, you will get like this. Okay, so our central atom here adalah adalah sulfur. Okay, so kalau you tengok dekat sulfur ni, we have 1 lone pair and 4 single bond. 1 lone pair, 4 single bond. So how many electron group? Yes, we have 5 electron group. So the type of hybridization should be sp3d. Di mana arrangement dia adalah trigonal bipyramidal. Okay, next, if we draw the Lewis structure for C2H2, you akan dapat macam ni. Ada triple bond. So here guys, we have 2 central atom. Kita ada 2 central atom, which is the carbon atom, but position dia sama. Means dia punya type of hybridization juga sama. So this carbon atom consists of 1 single bond and 1 triple bond. So how many electron group? Yes, 2 electron group, bukan 4 ya. Because we treat the triple bond as single bond. Kita anggap satu triple bond bersamaan satu electron group. So the type of hybridization is sp. Okay, next we have silicon tetrachloride. So this is the Lewis structure. So silicon is our central atom. So look around the silicon here, consists of 4 single bond. So 4 single bond equal to 4 electron group. So what is the type of hybridization? Yes, sp3. And the last question, we have xenon tetrafluoride. So this is the Lewis structure. And look here, how many electron group here? Okay, tengok, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 single bond and 2 lone pair. Total, yes, we have 6 electron group. So the type of hybridization is sp3d2. Okay guys, that's all for part 1 or the introduction for subtopic 4.3. Later, I will continue with drawing the orbital overlapping in the next part. Thank you class. Bye.